Well, I think it's a story about love and forgiveness, and that out of tragedy can come healing and closure, done in a comedic way. But you know, it's my favorite kind of movie. It's funny, but it also has you know, a lot of pathos and reality in it. I think my character is terrific. I just love this character. I really wanted to play her. I wanted to work in this kind of comedy, which is my favorite kind. As I said, it's both funny with a, you know, you laugh and you cry, with Sean and this terrific stable of actors. I mean, it's unusually incredible cast. The ecology of families are very complex. A lot of different people born of parents that aren't necessarily, I was gonna say normal, but who knows what normal is, you know, that have their own issues that are passed along. So there's all kinds of tensions and rivalries and jealousies and misunderstandings and, you know, it's fertile soil for drama, and it's fertile soil for comedy too. It depends on, you know, on the angle that you approach it from. But because families are intense, just because of that's the nature of families, it's great for storytelling. It's an easy movie for a lot of people to identify with. I love my children very much, but I'm a woman who has a touch of narcissism, and I'm not very aware of boundaries. And, you know, this book that I've written, which is now going into its 25th edition, you know, I talk a lot about, I use my children as examples of how to handle children and child rearing, and it you know, it gets pretty personal, and my children resent it a lot. Well, most of my scenes are with Jason Bateman, and one of the things that I saw and pleased me very much is his, he has a lot of, his emotions are very accessible. You know, we have some very touching scenes, and it's right there, you know, it's good. He can, he's not just a comedian, he's a real actor. And can be very, very moving. It's unusual that the writer of the novel on which a movie is based is also the sole screenwriter, and he did a great job. You know, when you read the book, it's hard to see how it could be made into a movie, but with the help of the wonderful producer, Paula Weinstein, over a number of years, they got it just perfect. I mean, I'm really glad that he did it, because he kept the feeling of the novel that a lot of people like a lot. He's, you know, I've really worked with a director who misses nothing. He sees everything, every detail, a hair out of place, whatever it is, he's aware of it, both in front of the camera and what goes on the set every day. He seems to have unflagging energy and a very, very positive energy. He's an extremely buoyant, positive person. And he's just like one of the guys. I don't know, he's very, very loving and kind and considerate and very, very helpful for an actor. Corey Stoll, who, you know, maybe some people have seen in, well, he was Hemingway in Midnight in Paris, Woody Allen's movie, and he's in House of Cards, a very central character in House of Cards. He's an extraordinary actor, both very, very serious and very, very funny. Watching him work was terrific for me. And then this guy, Adam Driver, who is, you know, he came to fame in Girls, and I also just saw him in the new Coen Brothers film, and he was in Lincoln. He played the postmaster, and he's in Francis Ha. He's working a lot. He's going to be a huge star. He's the real deal. You know, it's unusual that you see a young actor who everything he does is completely original and completely brave, and it's been a thrill for me to work with him and to watch him. I'm smitten.